how do you see the EU's decision to impose tariffs on Chinese EVs and the impact from that move?
It's exactly the wrong decision by the European Union, because when China now can produce the best solar panels, best windmills, best electric cars and batteries in the world should applaud. And then, of course, Europe should shape the competition and say, we need to get up early in the morning, we need to be more innovative so that we can compete with China in going green. Green competition is not bad, that's good. It's a race to the top, while, of course, protectionism is a race to the bottom, because it will slow down the green transformation. And if I may add, it's also completely illogical. Look, this is an Apple phone. How come I, as a European, has an American phone? Because Apple has enormous overcapacity in phones. That's why it's the most valuable company on planet Earth. They can produce cellular phones for everyone, everywhere in the world who want to buy it. And that's overcapacity. When China now has overcapacity in electric cars or in solar panels, it's fantastic, it's good news. We want every nation to produce more green products, and we should facilitate them in the global markets rather than trying to stop them.
So in response to the EU's decision to impose tariffs, China has now imposed anti-dumping measures on brandy imports from the EU. It may also target EU pork products and large engine vehicles. Do you think a full-blown trade war is likely?
Fortunately, I don't think a big trade war is likely, but it must be avoided by all our powers, because it would be so negative. And time has come for China and the European Union to sit down at the table and find amendable solutions to everyone. Of course, you can understand that Europe wants jobs in Europe. If you are the president of France, you want jobs in France. If you are the chancellor of Germany, you want jobs in Germany. But the best answer to that is for Europe to invite the Chinese electric battery companies or solar panel makers or electric car companies like, say, BYD or Huawei to invest in Europe. Then there are get jobs in Europe and you get the technology transfer. By the way, this was exactly how China developed in the past. It invited European and American companies to invest in China to get the technologies and to provide jobs in China. Now it's reversed, and Europe should open up for Chinese competition in the European market. That will be very good for Europe, and of course also at the end good for China. But please sit down and talk and find solutions.